Right, so why are these squared? Right, so example, let's say you have like a yard, like grass yard. You say, well, how big is it? Oh, it's 40 square meters. And someone's like, I don't know what that is. Talk to me in square feet. You know, this is where the idea comes into here, where you can change square meters to square feet. Right, so 40 square meters, what does that look like? It can look like many different things, but let's say it's just this square area where you have 10 meters by 4 meters. So what is the area? Well, it's base times height, right? So let's say this is your base, 10 meters. This is your height, 4 meters. 10 times 4 is just 40. Meters times meters is meters squared. So that's where that comes into play. If we're talking volume, like if I give this a thickness of, let's say, 2 meters, well, the volume is base times height times width. So base 10 meters, height 4 meters, and a width of 2 meters. 10 times 4 times 2, we get 80, but meters times meters times meters, have cubic meters, right? So the quantities that you're talking about will be reflected by the units. If you see square or something, you're probably talking area. If you see cubic something, or like cubic length and square length, you're talking area, volume. Right, and so that's where these ideas of units to a power come into play. And so, let's talk about how to convert units to a power. So convert 40 square meters to feet to square feet. So first, write down what you're given. Given 40 meters squared. And so think of this like this. Meters squared is meters times meters. And we want to go to feet squared, which is feet times feet. Right? And so we can do one conversion. This up on the side, conversion between meters and feet. So we can do one of these, right? So let's cancel out 1 meter and get 1 foot. 1 meter, 3.281. And we see we canceled out one of the meters. So at this instance, we have 40 times 3.281 meters feet. That's not a helpful unit. And we want feet squared. So we gotta cancel out the other meters. The other meters. So we do it again. So we wanna cancel out this meter, put it on the bottom, put this feet on the top. Right, and so let me just do the same thing. And this meter cancels with that meter, and we're left with square feet. So putting that in the calculator, get about 430.6 square feet. Right, so this is like the expanded way of doing it. There's another way, same idea, it's just a little faster, maybe. So you start with what you're given. So you know you're going to have to cancel out meters twice. So you do your one conversion, put it inside parentheses, meters on the bottom, feet on top, 1 meter, 3.281 feet. You know you're going to do this step twice, so you square this. So this guy right here is equivalently doing this twice. And so this will give you square meters on the bottom and square feet on the top. And you see the meters cancel. And so if you punch this in your calculator, you get the exact same thing. And so if this one doesn't make sense now, I encourage you to practice so that this does make sense. Because in the next video, we'll do an example and we'll be doing it this way.